can go as far into the future as you'd like. But you should never forget your roots.
Never.
We're getting back to the roots of rock.
With Sister Tracy.
It's going to edumacate you. It's for Tina and Sean out in White City. Yeah, if you're listening, guys.
I think I might have talked about her a little, it's been a while back, but I just think her music deserves some more attention because it doesn't get any. Her whole career was almost, her life story was pretty much just undocumented until her daughter kind of brought it out of, you know.
Interesting.
Yeah, she was one of those people that, you know, the timing was as such that she ended up getting married and moving and never had a lot of success when she did record. So she just went and lived a regular life for most of her life. And then later on, it becomes kind of known that two or three of her recordings are contenders for the first rock and roll song ever.
You were saying that, like that she created the word rock and roll like in 49 or something.
Well, yeah, it was her 1949 song called Rock and Roll Blues, and it was the first jump blues song to use the phrase rock and roll.
Yeah, that's crazy, man. That's
when
early.
It wasn't used in a non-secular context.
Yeah.
Erline Harris. Yes, Arlene. Some people, she was billed under different names. Arlene, Elaine. But
oddly, toddly, whatever.
You know, and she did record, like I said, Rock and Roll Blues was a contender. Jump and Shout was another song that some music historians say is a contender for, you know, one of the first jump blues albums to cross over into rock and roll.
Tomato, tomato.
But 1949 and a woman, you know, she lived her whole life in obscurity, like never even thought about it again.
Weird.
And, you know, she passed away in 2004.
Well, check
and
it out.
And it wasn't even until after that that she was really talked about and discovered.
Well, in 2020, here we are talking about her.
Woo-hoo! It's pretty cool. And I'm going to go ahead and play the rock and roll blues one. Just
you get me excited, man. I'm about ready to wet myself with anticipation.
And like I said, keep in mind, this was recorded in 1949.
Wow.
So, you know, Elvis was still, you know, wearing knickers and playing marbles or whatever.
Elvis wasn't even the prince of rock yet, let alone the king.
Right? So give it up for Erline, and this is her nickname, Erline Rock and Roll Harris, doing rock and roll blues on the Church of Rock in KSKQ. I love my baby, he satisfies my soul.